Welcome to How It Works. On today's episode, I'll look at some of the latest features of Clearbrief, an AI-powered legal drafting platform that helps litigators find, organize, verify, and share the evidence that underlies their legal writing. Here today to tell us all about it and show us how it works is Jacqueline Schafer, the founder and CEO of Clearbrief, along with Tim Parker, account executive at Clearbrief. Jackie and Tim, welcome to the show. Jackie, let me start off with you before we get to the demo. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Clearbrief in general and what you do?
Absolutely. Clearbrief is the leading AI litigation drafting platform, and we're trusted by thousands of legal organizations, including the largest global law firms, investigators, courts, throughout every stage of the legal writing journey without requiring constant switching between tools. So what's unique about Clearbrief is that we provide a curated set of classic AI tools that are not generative AI, as well as generative AI tools that are all deployed inside Microsoft Word so that they can interact with the user's Word document throughout their entire writing process while supporting references to hundreds of thousands of source documents for creating timelines, deposition summaries, tables of key facts, and then summarizing them all into fact sections with citations. And the source documents and of those citations are always viewable, easily clickable from inside Word. So what we like to say is it's AI that doesn't give the partner a heart attack because they can easily click and see, and they can always have access to those sources. Then still inside Clearbrief, the paralegals can take over and they can use Clearbrief for site checking. We integrate with LexisNexis and Fastcase VLex for those authentic legal sources. You can generate your table of authorities and exhibits with a click because it knows which things you've referenced in your writing. And then you can end by hyperlinking that document for filing with the court, for sharing with an arbitrator, or for sharing with the executive team and the client so that they can get this interactive experience.
Great. Well, I'm sure people are eager to see how it works. And let me just note to viewers that if you want to at any point jump ahead to any point in the demonstration, we've got chapter markers in the video, you can jump ahead through the different parts of it. But Tim, I understand you're going to walk us through it. So why don't you go ahead and show us how it works?
Let's go for it. Thank you, Bob. We'll start with the generative tools and then get to our original suite. As Jackie mentioned, Clearbrief is a Word add-in. So here I am in Word. We do a single sign-on in a centralized deployment, so users have an easy time getting in. This dark tile at the top right of my home tab is how we access Clearbrief. I'm on one screen today, so I just drag my add-in window across. This also pops out if the user has two screens. The first thing I want to do today is create a timeline. This Matter dashboard, buttons, and dropdowns contain all of Clearbrief's features. If we're just looking to create a timeline using our generative AI, the first step would be to upload your documents as we begin this trail on our flow. There's several ways to upload documents. We integrate with several document management systems. You can always drag and drop folders, including large zips, right into this blue rectangle. The documents are uploaded into the cloud, either the AWS cloud, which comes with the subscription, and some of our big law firm customers choose to bring their own storage so that they can assure to their clients that the data they provide is always in their environment. You can see the OCRing happens automatically. You can also customize how you cite these records and add bait stamps. So this is a real estate-based litigation. If I'm at the outset of a case and voluminous documents are already being swapped by the parties and I just need to get a quick handle on what's happened here, I'm going to use Clearbrief's generative tools. Under the purple dropdown, I can create a hyperlinked timeline. Select all the files you want included in the timeline and feel free to curate this timeline. If you have an idea at the outset of the discrete case issues that you want to focus on, you can follow this workflow and enter a few concepts into the bar. When you generate, Clearbrief will show you your progress through this window, but the compute does not happen on your machine. So you can close out and Clearbrief will let you know when your work product is complete. You're able to access again under the purple dropdown, save tables and drafts folder. As mentioned, this is a real estate-based litigation. I'm at the outset of the case. I'm using Clearbrief to help me understand the basics. We get to this window here where there's different outputs you can select, kind of a small, medium, large option. The differences are described here on the right. Clearbrief has extracted every date from my records. So through these dropdowns, I can adjust the date range, giving me more control over the output. Some of our big law customers use this feature to summarize tens of thousands of emails, and they may want columns that are email specific. Because I don't, mostly these documents are real estate contracts. I'm going to deselect those and give you a view of the output. Clearbrief's generative timeline is on the left, hyperlinked to all the source records on the right. So we're able to verify the accuracy of the Gen AI just through this split screen right here. Taking a quick look, we can see particular case events, a generative description, and a hyperlink that snaps us to that portion in the record. So that we're able to verify with our own eyes, these are real facts in the case. That's the hyperlink timeline. Are there any questions there?
So just real quick, when you were first selecting the documents that you want to add to the timeline, is there any ability to preview the documents at that point?
Absolutely. There's a bundle of search features that you can use to get a look at the documents. You can control how they're named very easily within Clearbrief. So if you don't want them to be Exhibit R, but you want them to be real estate lease, you can do that. And as we'll see in a moment, there's ways for you to quickly search and get visibility into all your records. Now we're going to take a look at another Clearbrief generative AI tool by summarizing a transcript.
So one thing I wanted to add here is, as you can see, we have a new user interface that really mirrors the process that the user is going through with their writing. And it does sort of illustrate how Clearbrief is unique, where other AI tools are really focused on just the step of generating text. That's an issue that we hear a lot that, okay, I generated text, but now I have to send this to the partner and I have to send this to my colleague to work on it. And they don't have access, even if that generated text had citations, they don't have access to the sources anymore. So there's this fear and loss of trust that, oh gosh, we use generative AI. The partner is worried about signing off on this pleading. And as we've seen, there was just another case that came out this week in Wyoming where the attorneys were sanctioned and they said, if you're signing that document, you need to have read the citations. So this is really solving that issue so that if you do use the generative AI tools, they're clearly marked here with their own section, as you can see, that purple section. And if you're not comfortable using generative AI, you can still benefit from all the other AI tools that are not generative AI. But as you'll see, when you use the generative AI tools, they're always including a citation back to that source so that everyone who touches the document, whether it's, you know, starting the initial stage of uploading and searching and building your case all the way through to filing, they can always have visibility into the sources.
So the point being, it's clear when you're using a generative AI source and a generative AI tool and when you're not.
Exactly.
Excellent. So let's create a summary of a transcript. It gets its own button here in the purple dropdown, as mentioned. This is a legal transcript, and I'm going to put it into a table. This happens to be a deposition, but certainly we have customers who summarize several days of trial testimony. Again, I could put a focus on this if I were so inclined. Click Generate and Clearbrief will show me my progress here. Same as before, it doesn't jam up your system. When the output is ready for you, you can go back into the purple dropdown, into your save tables, pull up the summary. What level of comprehension you want is up to you. You can add columns for the reasons and the topics. These would be searches that you ran or Clearbrief gleaning the substance of the testimony itself. We've worked closely for several months with our big law and other partners on what exact output they want. One thing we heard was that an executive summary at the top to give the user a 2-minute understanding of the testimony would be helpful. So that's what you can see here. Down into the actual hyperlinked generative AI summary. As mentioned by Jackie, this is what gives you visibility into the source of truth on the right, generative description of the testimony, hyperlink to show you where that came from in your records. Are there any questions on this feature?
That's very clear. Thank you.
Now we'll take a look at Clearbrief's original suite of search tools. So I've got an outline here, and I'm imagining I'm at the outset of a case where I'm an associate on the team. We've just been brought in. We need to understand the evidence, what positions we're able to stake out in this litigation. So I'll click into a Clearbrief matter folder that I've prepared for this. Back in the same dashboard, I'm going to click this button, Analyze. I've already uploaded my source documents. When we analyze, Clearbrief hyperlinks and scores any citation I have in my document. That's factual and legal. Over here on the left, I'm asserting this yellow sentence. The governor discussed infidelity, etc. I've cited transcript page 5. Clearbrief brings that record up for my viewing on the right. I can see right away, this is just an appearances page. This is not helpful evidence. I also know that because Clearbrief has scored the site. Right in the middle of my screen, I'm seeing a meter with two orange bars. Intuitively, I'm understanding I need better evidence. And a really cool thing that Clearbrief has done for me is locate that better evidence and bring it right to my screen. I'm searching across potentially millions of pages. I have high hopes for these records that Clearbrief has brought me because I'm seeing this high score here. Sure enough, as I click in, I'm getting taken to sections that track my yellow assertion. The verbiage is totally different, but the concept is the same. So Clearbrief's AI is casting a wide net, locating similar concepts in my records, and I can add those as citations just by clicking plus. In it goes. Another way to search is highlight any text you want to support. Clearbrief won Litigation Technology of the Year at Legal Week for this. All we have to do is highlight whatever we're looking to support, click add fact cite. Clearbrief will round up all the helpful evidence, and I can review it quickly, clicking down these records, finding the most supportive piece of evidence, and adding it with a click. The final way to search that I want to show you is what we call table building. You may have noticed this concept bar on the right. It works like any search engine you're used to using. You can type in concepts, keywords, Boolean logic. Here, the public official in question was alleged to have passed flowers out to particular colleagues. So if I want to quickly round up that evidence, I just type in the word roses. I see my results here, and I'm going to put them into a table, beginning with a blank table. I can review these hits one at a time and make a decision about how helpful they are. Or I can click this double plus right here. We're able to verify the accuracy of each assertion by clicking on the hyperlink and getting a view into that source record on the right. Any questions on this feature before we bring up our last brief?
No, just to be clear, though, that as you're clicking on the citations on the right and adding them into the document on the left, you can do that multiple times. It doesn't have to be just pick one citation, right?
Well, absolutely. As many as you want, across as many records as you want, and you can run as many different searches as you want. So it's a versatile tool.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks.
And lastly, we've got a brief that was filed on the Ninth Circuit. We're going to analyze this brief. It's going to give us a chance to show off our partnership with LexisNexis and work toward finalization. So Clearbrief has analyzed my writing for me. That's to say, it's hyperlinked every legal citation, case law, statutes and court rules, and evidence too. I'm able to assess the strength of my argument side by side, beginning with this citation to the Marino case. If I'd included a pin site, it would snap straight to that page. But through our partnership with Lexis, we can review the strength of our arguments. I'm also noticing an exclamation point here. When I click on that, it's showing me that I've got some citational mistakes that Clearbrief detected automatically. Briefly, it points out that this citation should be a short cite. You'll notice I've got the full cite to Marino at the top of the paragraph, and then again at the bottom. Clearbrief is giving me the opportunity to correct that blue booking in one click. I can continue along these lines for every citation, and when I'm ready to finalize, I can add a table of authorities with just a few clicks. Here we have a full and complete table of authorities on the left, pursuant to whatever formatting my jurisdiction requires, and in the editing panel on the right that allows me to review each citation. And if I come across a red hyperlink, I can continue that cite checking, whether it's a grammar mistake or a blue booking error. But everything looks good to me, and I'm ready to hyperlink this. That is, submit a hyperlinked PDF to the neutral, whether that's a judge or an arbitrator. Clearbrief has partnered with the American Arbitration Association. Neutrals prefer to receive these PDFs we're going to create right here. But here we have a fully hyperlinked Clearbrief that we would submit to the neutral, and they're going to be able to access all of the hyperlinks, even if they don't have Clearbrief downloaded or are not a Clearbrief subscriber. So if the neutral needs to verify a particular factual assertion or legal citation, they're going to have a very easy time following the hyperlinks into a split screen where the work product is presented on the left, and the source of truth is always viewable on the right. So that includes statutes, as here, evidence, and case law too. For example, if a judge needs to verify that a particular standard of review is correctly stated, we've snapped straight to the page, making for a very easy decision by the judge.
And just to be clear, you said the neutral doesn't have to be a Clearbrief subscriber. Do they have to be a LexisNexis subscriber to see the content in LexisNexis?
They do not. And so this is a versatile tool that's used by sending documents to law firm clients, judges, arbitrators, and the like.
And we also have exclusive partnership with the American Arbitration Association. So arbitrators are using Clearbrief, and also they're asking parties to the arbitration to use it as well. So if you are interested in learning more about that and getting trained up in anticipation of an arbitration, you can always reach out at hello@clearbrief.ai.
And I am a AAA arbitrator, so I'm glad to know about that.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I am. Yep. You know, it's just a quick comment, because every time I've seen parts of this product before, obviously demonstrated, and every time I see it, it just strikes me that there's nothing else out there on the market that does what Clearbrief does. There's a lot of copycat products out there in the world that where they each do the same thing. This is so unique in terms of what you do. That's what really makes it interesting.
Thank you so much, Bob, for saying that. Yeah, I really think the time that we've spent in the trenches making Clearbrief interact with Word documents, it's just very, very difficult. It's, like I said, generating text. A lot of people can generate text. It's how can we actually make that useful to you in the Word document for your writing process? That's the really, really hard part. And it's because of our close work with our customers across the spectrum, the solo firms, the largest law firms, the arbitrators, the judges, the in-house teams, that we've really captured a lot of those nuances and their pain points about what it's like to write when you're constantly having to reference a million different things.
All right. Well, I really appreciate this demonstration. It's great to see it. Anything else you'd like to add quickly before we wrap up?
Just that the other thing that I think is unique about us is our personal touch. Most of the folks on the team, you know, who are interacting with customers do have a legal background. We really consider it an important part of our mission to train people in the platform. So every tool in Clearbrief, I don't know if you noticed this, has a little video that's associated with it. So if you want to, you know, get on a call with us, you can do that. We'll sit with you when you have a brief due. Or if you want to, you know, just watch a video really quick in the middle of the night when you're working on your pleading, we can do that. And Clearbrief is also available and used in other countries, including in Europe, in the UK, as well as Canada. And we do support automatically displaying the law in those jurisdictions as well.
Well, Tim and Jackie, thanks so much for showing us all about it today. I really appreciate it. And listeners, that's it for today's episode of How It Works. A reminder, you can find all of our episodes on YouTube. Just search for How It Works there. We're also on the LawNext Legal Tech Directory at directory.lawnext.com under the Resources tab. You can find us there. This is Bob Ambrogi. Thanks for watching.